Hey everybody! Welcome back to Northern Lion Plays, The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Fair to say, I've been having a little bit of an off day here. We did get that Eden Lamb kill. Lazarus became so close. Fun run regardless, though. I think, you know what? Let's do an Eve run. Wait, is there anybody? Blue Baby still has not beaten Satan? Oh, it's burning a hole in my heart for that to exist. I say we do a Maggie run regardless. It's been a little while. We don't need to unlock everything with all characters before we do anything else. Our seed today, SLFB, Super Loud Facebook PTKC, Super Loud Facebook Players Take Kansas City. It's coming this fall to your theater near you. Get ready. White Feather, right off the bat, really? Not super excited about that, but we'll check it out, you know. Yelmheart's good, ish, sort of. We might actually roll with Guppy's Paw instead. Maybe a Guppy run is exactly what we need to break out of this funk. I kind of wanted to try out Crack the Sky, but at the same time, I'm going to roll with Guppy's Paw for now. And, you know, if we'd imagined that item room just contained Guppy's Paw instead of Crack the Sky, we probably wouldn't be that mad, right? So let's not be that mad. This is a decent start. We'll pursue Guppy items in the future. Not promising any, you know, special Dark Angel kills. Jessica Alba, she dips beneath the lasers. Different brunettes from the late 90s and early 2000s, but that's okay. Maggie is one of those characters that I must admit, in Rebirth, it's kind of like nothing special, you know? It's like Leia Jackson from your public school, you know? She does her work. She doesn't get great grades, but she does okay. She works hard. She's got an after-school job. A little plain, but a nice lady, all things considered. You know, it's like Bobby Johansson, you know? He plays football. He's the second-string quarterback. He's not going to make it in the majors, but, you know, he's a nice enough fellow. That's how I feel about Maggie. Maggie's okay. It starts with a little bit of extra HP, but there's really nothing that makes, that gives Maggie a hook, you know? There's no edge to Maggie. Which sometimes is what you need, is just a bit of a tanky run to make your life a little easier. Well, absolutely, we'll put a bomb here. And then I would say, absolutely, we'll put a bomb here. We're actually gonna earn two bombs in the process, which is pretty solid. And then I say we put a bomb here as well to get this Spirit Heart, but we won't get the Spirit Heart yet. We'll just unlock it. Dingle, all right, time to put my money where my mouth is. What's the secret to fighting Dingle? He's easy. You just learn his pattern, dodge that shot, and then when he does his, like, triplicate kind of bullshit charge move, you just put yourself up here where it's safe. He runs into the poop and then he gets tired. That's his whole thing. Dingle does not have the cardiovascular strength to do the kind of damage that makes him a dangerous boss. Now, we're just trying to keep those little Dingles away. Hide behind the poop. Hide behind the poop. I will never understand when people tell me that Dingle is harder than Gurglings. I know people are like, oh, shut the fuck up about Dingle and Gurglings. Every video you're talking about Dingle and Gurglings. But I still do have these Gurglings apologists who say, hey man, Gurglings aren't that hard. I'm not saying, you know, they're the hardest boss in the game or anything like that. But look at this Dangle here. Dangle does nothing to you. You just hide behind the poop. It's the easiest thing in the whole world. If you have a better methodology for fighting Gurglings, I don't want to hear it. They move all the time. They create creep. They get up in your grill. They try to take you to a hotel. They must be a football coach the way they got you playing the field, so let me give you that dude. Well, Pageant Boy. With the release of Rebirth, my thoughts on Pageant Boy have kind of gone back to where they used to be, which is that Pageant Boy is just not good enough. There are a lot better... forget our secret room here. There's a lot better choices as far as items from bosses go. Looks like we got the cellar here again. Pride is a really easy fight. I wish its bombs hurt it, but that's okay. I'll tell you what, I would rather fight Dingle any day of the week than fight Pride, and I would probably rather fight Pride than any other boss, any other mini-boss, I should say. You know, get away from me, please, bombs. Look, I'm not trying to rain on Dingle's parade. I know for a while I took damage against him all the time, but once you figure out that pattern, man, I think it's pretty easy. Gurglings have got that unpredictable kind of entropy nature, you know? What's the Newton's fourth law of thermodynamics? Fuck gurglings. He said it in a more regal tone. I mean, it was the Renaissance, but the sentiment remains the same. Well, we can do this, you know, the easy way or the hard way. That key is very interesting. I am going to have to go to that big room, but let's try to skirt our way around it first, just in case we can maybe get lucky and maybe get a good item on our item room prior to going there. Our damage actually seems like okay, and that scares me because I had Mom's knife on our last run. You'd think I'd be miscalibrated here. You'd think I'd be thinking that our damage is superb. Or on the last run, and then shitty on this run, but I'm actually feeling pretty okay about it. Come on. Yeah, there we go. What's our tarot card? Wheel of Fortune. Not really very good. What we can do, and I'm going to try it here. It's maybe a bit of a poor play because we could use our bombs to get to the secret room, but let's try something a little different. Get the heck out of here. I would rather fight Dingle than these guys. And you know, the data doesn't lie. I took damage against these guys. Mind you, I played worse. Let's put Wheel of Fortune down here and blow up two pots and the slot machine. That gave us two bombs and a send. I'd say that was actually a fairly decent deal. We could probably get four pots with a bomb there. It's a bit risky though. All right, there's a curse room. That's something we'll save for after the boss fight. It'll take us a little while to get this guy to break apart the way I want him to. I hope there's not four of him. I hope there's only two, but I have a sneaking suspicion that we may indeed be seeing four of them. I don't know. There was only one on that side. Yeah, okay, maybe there's only two. Okay. Let's do it. These guys, you know, they get hoisted by the same petard there. There's poops in the way. Ooh. You guys remember the Nirvana song. So we have magnetic tears. Magnetic tears are one of the most divisive items in the game right now. Sometimes they can be lovely, sometimes they can be horrible. I'm trying to like shoot them through the wall here, it's sort of working. I'm thinking that they'll probably be terrible for us right now until we can come across some better synergy for them. Because look at what they do to these spiders. The spider just like chases us down basically without even using its own free will. So we're going to hope for some synergy here. Like, I don't even know. Maybe technology would synergize well with it. I'm just spitballing here. These are just guesses. Pin. Yeah, we'll chariot. That was very easy. Happy to have the HP tiers up and shot speed down. Well, the shot speed down maybe a little bit less so. I'm going to take the pact. I know it's an obvious play. I'm going to throw a bomb down there just in case. Just in case, you know. And I thought about taking Headless Baby, because especially with magnetic shots, it seems to make sense that if we created creep in front of us, it would annoy the crap out of our enemies a little bit. Gonna look for our secret room and hopefully be able to make something happen shop-wise. Gamgee. Let's bring up our map. Well, the most likely place for the secret room would then be directly above this room. Please work out for me. Not gonna shoot at it, because our magnetic tears would probably bung it up for everybody. One pretty fly, two pretty flies. That's actually really good for us. And lockdown, which doesn't surprise me. And I think I am gonna go to our curse room because we already have one guppy item. So I think going to our curse room gives us a good chance of getting the guppy, the dream, basically. And it worked out. It didn't give us a guppy item, but it did well for us. And we're going to save our money. We're going to save our key. We're going to head down to the next floor. And I'm feeling pretty good about this with the asterisk, the caveat, that straight up, I am a little concerned about the implications of having magnetic tears. I've had a great magnetic tears run. It was magnetic, shielded tears, and Ludovico technique. It was amazing. The tears... magnetized all the enemies, put them all in the same location, and then shielded the crap out of anything they shot at me. So I was basically, you know, I had almost no risk to myself on that entire run. It was very good. But that could change on this run. Who knows, right? Like, these enemies are chasing me down pretty quickly. Come to me. Come to me. No? Okay, well, I tried. More than enough keys. Our item room contains mysterious liquid, toxic splash damage, which actually seems... First off, we're basically Sam Fisher right now. I'm loving that. But it seems like this might actually be okay. Because As enemies get sucked into these tears, they'll also get hit by the toxic splash damage. One thing I will say is, I'm very not surprised that magnetic tears have been such a divisive item thus far. I think they're risky, but fun. I'm totally gonna buy the champion's belt. Sure, fanny pack is okay as well. Gives us money every time you get hit. We could probably, you know, as nice as this run has been so far, with magnetic tears, we could probably expect to get hit, right? I would like to buy fanny pack, but champion's belt, you know, just a little bit stronger, I think. That's never gonna work out for ourselves. I thought maybe we could sneak some of those coins out of the little tiny corner there, but I don't think so. And damage upgrades seem like pretty much the most important upgrades for us that we could possibly get, because if these enemies are gonna be rushing us down as a result of the, you know, incontrovertible electromagnetic force, it would be nice if we killed them fairly quickly so that we didn't, you know, put ourselves in harm's way for too long. Pretty good start. And HP, so this is a lazy floor. By what I mean by that is that we pretty much just go through the motions on this one. We don't have any kind of fancy footwork or anything that we have to do. We're probably gonna go to our curse room. But it's a good floor, and I'm happy that we're in the position that we're in. But I would love to have a slightly better chance of becoming Guppy, because those flies would do an awful lot of good stuff against these enemies that are gonna be rushing me down. All right. We're gonna look for our secret room? We probably should, huh? We'll take a look, maybe we can buy fanny pack. All right, never mind. Curse room. Guppy items. Sign me up. We actually gotta deal with the devil out of it. Hmm. You know what? I think we can make better use of Book of Belial than Guppy's Paw. Hey, we got the goat head too. That's actually huge for us. So it's a bit aggressive here, but I think this is a smart play. Guppy's head, I have not really experimented with using productively in Rebirth. In vanilla, it's a no-brainer. You just use it until you have no more red hearts. You could have 30 hearts, like, off the screen. But I think Book of Belial is a little bit better for us. And with our goat head, we'll now be able to give ourselves the best chance possible of becoming Guppy. I can't believe we didn't get hit there. So this is hard to get used to, but there are probably times with magnetic tears that it's best for me not to fire. Like if one of those dingles is rushing me down, don't fire. That seems like probably the right course of action to take, but it's gonna be very difficult to get used to that. Now, I'm actually loving the fact that we get to fight these enemies, even though I usually find them annoying. The fact that they're kind of stuck to the ground is actually a nice change of pace. Good. Oh, Holy Mantle. It's so good. Okay, so Holy Mantle is actually amazing for us in all contexts, but in this context, it's incredible. If you haven't seen Holy Mantle yet, what it does is it nullifies the first bit of damage that you take on a room. It's actually like an incredible item. I don't know how it got into the game. It must be pretty rare because it's so good. How many rooms in Isaac do you take multiple hits on? It's pretty rare. Most of the time you get whittled down like one hit at a time. Stay away, please. So if we take damage on this room, for example, which we totally could now, we actually wouldn't take damage. It's an extremely valuable item. One that I've, you know, asked to see a lot, and yet the game says no, but then on this run, for whatever reason, the game says yes. Oh, God. Don't message me on Steam, please. It creates this awful frame rate. Literally, that happened, like, the instant the Steam message popped up. So you'll have to give me a second here after we finish this room. In the meantime, just enjoy slow motion. This is not my PC's problem. I'm very sorry about this, my friends. That sounds like a great run. Says he just got Sacred Heart as Azazel. Where's my Sacred Heart game? We're gonna go offline, we're gonna tab back in here, and then if you give this just a minute, it'll work itself out. I guarantee it. There we go. See, I'm like the Rebirth dog whisperer. I'm figuring out how to how to deal with the Rebirth issues that arise, and some of them do arise. You know, it's not a perfectly made game. There are still some issues. You know, I had those terrible save bugs for a couple days. It's still very likely to be my favorite game of the year, which is gonna surprise nobody, but still. Those frame rate issues are kind of annoying. It happens every time I alt-tab as well. You know, maybe it is my computer's problem, but this thing's pretty good. It should be able to handle Rebirth. But I don't know, maybe there's some crazy stuff going on behind the scenes. Maybe there's actually like a AAA first-person shooter built into Rebirth that's the real secret right there. So I'm happy to have a snack, a little dog bone for some HP up. And Krampus is apparently exceptionally light, which is bumming me out right now. Because when he shoots at me, he actually gets attracted to me, which is not great. So I would kiss our spirit hearts goodbye, probably. I don't know how Mysterious Liquid's doing for us. I know so many people have told me that Mysterious Liquid is so good. I have never really had a great situation with it. You know, I am using Krampus' head. I know it shows up all the effing time. I think it's better than Book of Belial. It basically gives us an instant kill on a room. So I think it's the best choice. I wish I hadn't taken that deal with the devil for, wait a minute. I've still got Book of Belial here. I wish I hadn't taken that deal for Book of Belial, but Krampus' head, you know, I'd be denying myself the best chance at the win if I didn't take it. Bomb for a key doesn't seem like a great trade for us. I'll use Book of Belial on this room because it's, you know, it's got a life expectancy. It's got an expiration date. Magnetic tears are proving to be like the risk-reward balance that we thought they would be. A little bit of a penny back there. We should go back and get it. I will get Krampus' head, by the way, when we leave. We have goat heads, so it's not like we're going to miss out on it. What floor are we on, anyway? Catacombs 2. Could be an arcade. Might like to get into that boss trap room. Please die fast. Please die quickly, I guess I should say. It is one of the few bonuses of magnetic tears. When it sucks an enemy towards you, we can kind of catch them in these choke points and not have to venture out into the risky abyss ourselves. You remember Risky Abyss? It's Tom Cruise's breakout role. He plays as Friedrich Nietzsche. Now, we're gonna hang back here. I'm still very skeptical. I think the way that this run works out in our favor is if we just stack up damage upgrades to the point where basically an enemy gets sucked into the tears and then dies. The problem is right now they get sucked into the tears and then they kind of bounce around a little bit and then the, you know, Andre Ampere's magical, mystical, wonderful law kind of works against me a little bit. With Holy Mantle, by the way, we can go to secret rooms, curse rooms for free, as you just saw. So Holy Mantle's a good start for us on this run, but I really do think it's going to all come down to damage upgrades in the end. But in the end, actually, I guess I should be taking Linkin Park's advice and remembering that in the end it actually just doesn't really matter at all, so. But that's like a very nihilistic kind of viewpoint of the world. That's not how I choose to live my life, you know? What do we got here? Enough money to make the shop worthwhile. That's what I was hoping we'd get here. And Magnetic Tears allows us to not have to walk over the spikes there. You're not firing brimstone, that's good for me, and why do we have flies? These must have come from the chest, right? There's a tinted rock there. Hard to see. Obvious if you're looking, but not so much if you're not. Okay, let's see what we got here. Tons of money. Oh, jeez. Well, it is going to be our last use of Book of Belial, so I don't think that's terrible. Greed, I hate these lightweight enemies, man. Greed, you got to pack on some mass, buddy. Not working out too much in my favor here, but we did pick up a staggering amount of cash. Walked right onto that. Thank you, Holy Mantle. Oh, and we found our secret room too. Didn't even have to use a key, but we have more keys than bombs, so no big deal. Come here, please. Thank you, and then you guys come back this way. 50 cents. That's pretty good. Money equals power would be an extraordinary pickup for us. Let's get Krampus' head. Get the heck out of Dodge here. I don't know how I like this run long term, but we do have HP. We've got the necessary ingredients. We've just got one wild card here with this fucking magnet shot. But I've had, like, Ludovico Technique or Shielded Tears, either of those, we know. They have a demonstrated effect. They make the magnetic tears pretty good. It's like the basil on the pizza, you know? Don't tell me you don't put basil on your pizza. Some things I just refuse to believe. I don't think I'm going to get that chest. Yeah, I don't think it's worth the bomb. I think we got better uses for our... Oh, jeez. All right, zombies. It seems okay. All we've got to do is get them stuck on one trajectory and then use magnetic tears when they've turned the other way. Because that seems to allow us to kind of hold them in place and do even more damage. But they are very lightweight, aren't they? They're slipping and sliding around like crazy here. Alright, this is a legitimate room. Flies are like the exact... This is a microcosm of what I want to happen on our entire run. Enemies get killed in one hit. So far, it's not working out like that. One day, perhaps. These guys do get slowed and speeded based on where they are. Okay. High damage. Or, like, you know what else would be great? Mom's Contact would be great. I don't know that we're going to be able to swing that. I've only seen Mom's Contact once. On Rebirth. I've seen it a few times in Vanilla. Oh, I've seen it a few times. Ladies. Brimstone, yeah. If there's only one of you, it's definitely going to be a Brimstone one at this point in the game. Magician, interesting. You know, I will say that I think that it's conceivable that if we got Bent Spoon, that could be one of the most valuable items we could possibly pick up. All right, so I think if we just stay very, very far away, these guys aren't going to be so bad. That's exactly how that went down. No consumable drop. And a second large room. Yeah, I don't like it. We lost our Holy Mantle shield already. Actually, these guys are not so bad. As long as they just stay in line. No, no, you don't understand. You can't turn around. Okay, I... Not only did I take damage, I used Krampus Rage, and I didn't finish off the whole room. So I'm really proud of myself right now. We got a bomb back. That's not that worthwhile. We got 9 keys, though. This could be a big item room. Ipecac. I don't even know, but I gotta take it just for science, right? It seems like it could be great. I'm just gonna sort that room out right away. Genuinely, seems like it could be great. Or it does also scare the shit out of me a little bit. Yeah, I'll give you that. Cool. That's a luck downgrade. Thanks for nothing, asshole. What do we got going on up here? A special room? So now that Ipecac explodes... Oh my god. Okay, so what's the good? Well, the good news is the enemies get sucked into the explosions. What's the bad? If those enemies are close to me, I will also get sucked into both the enemy and the explosion. But I guess with the... With Holy Mantle, maybe it's not so bad. But you can say whatever you want. But you can't say that we don't have an interesting run here. With the exception, maybe, of Krampus's head, which we've had, like, the last 3 runs in a row. Yeah, this is gonna be a wild one. I think this might be great. And this would really make up for that, you know, Ipecac quad shot, rubber cement, Bob's brain I had. Sad bombs, etc., etc. Oh, that guy doesn't die until the other ones die. I got it. Easy. Oh my god, he's actually going to give us an eternal heart, too. What do you got, kid? The gates. Weirdly enough, Krampus's head was probably overkill there. We get a spirit heart. And a deal with the devil, of course. Damage upgrade. I do believe that scales with Ipecac. Yes, absolutely, I will take Lord of the Pit. Doesn't seem to give us extra speed here. But just being able to fly gives us a huge advantage, because we can stay far, far away from where our Ipecac shots are going to land. Two of Hearts, Stars, or what's the other one? The Magician. I do think Two of Hearts potentially... I mean, it's a potential run saver, so I'm going to roll with it. No greed this time, please. Alright, so we have... got a couple of things. That's bigger flies and spiders. I'll take it just in case we end up getting Guppy somehow. Portable slot we don't need. I'll buy the pill just to see what it is. It's well worth it. And then you know what? I'll do this too. And while we're here, why don't we try to donate enough money? I know we still have one more floor remaining. But we can get to 300 and still have 15... No, we can get to 300 and still have 10 cents. I just like to get to 300 in general, though. There's 15. Come on. Get it done. 298, 299, 300. No upgrade for that. That's okay. We tried. Ooh, second secret room. Okay, ooh, second secret room. It is Whipworm. I think it makes our shots faster. Like, every second shot is faster. I don't know. We'll take it. We haven't really used them yet. Okay, so we're definitely... This is Depths 1, yeah. We're definitely not going Boss Rush. Otherwise, the Stars card actually could have been sweet. But cool. We'll move along here. Depths 2. Glad we got that HP. Feeling pretty strong. And this Maggie run is kind of coming together here. Don't come over here. Don't ever touch me. It didn't really work. I think we might actually benefit from having slow shot speed, weirdly enough. Yeah, I'm so mad about that. But we have Holy Mantle, we actually managed to make it work. Even though I should have taken damage on the way in, we still had invincibility. Yeah, we don't have the visual effect for Holy Mantle anymore, but that doesn't really matter. Yeah. Well, thank you, Holy Mantle. I think I'm gonna drop Whipworm. I might be missing out on the effect or something, but I think we're better off without it. Slower shot speed actually seems better for us. Alright, I'm liking this. So far, so good. I think we may have actually managed to piece together a winning run, and that would make it almost perfect for me, I think, with Magnetic Tears. Which is a surprise. Pin, right? We didn't get the second or third kill. That's okay. At least hit somebody. I mean, I'm far away, so they're like always gonna pop up in the same place. Yeah. So this doesn't bother me too much. I would like it maybe if they just died, though. There we go. Extra penny. And this is a big floor. I could see this floor working out very amazingly for us. Like, especially if we could... Ugh, what a waste. But if we could become Guppy on this run... Maybe it wasn't. We got a penny out of it. But if we could become Guppy on this run... I'm pretty sure our flies would do a stupid amount of damage. We probably wouldn't generate that many of them. But maybe that's okay. And I'm just happy that we've turned Magnetic Tears from, like, the focus of our run into just, like, a nice little... bonus, as opposed to being like, is this what's gonna end our run for better or for worse? Probably for worse, though, let's be honest. Charm Tears. So assuming these actually work with Ipecac, that's awesome. I have no reason to believe that they won't. Should be looking for secret rooms. That's, it's just lazy not to. Especially when you find them on the first play. Got very lucky as well. And just got a, black card back there. We should go back for it. Why am I not going back for it? I was trying to see if maybe we could save a key by going into the shop through one of these doors. No, but we did find our boss room. We were so close to actually being able to do boss rush here, but it's not that big of a deal. I'm mostly just happy that we seem very strong right now. So we'll keep looking out for our shop. One of the only things that kind of excites me in terms of making our run better. Well, that's not true, because we still have the deals with the devil as well. Obviously, we're taking our health upgrade. And we can take every deal with the devil, so we will. Well, maybe not take every deal with the devil. We can see every deal with the devil, so we will. I think we're finally going to get out of this slump. Bag of pills. Normally, I would say no to this. But because we have a little bit of money and we know there's health upgrade pills, why not take a crack at it? That's two Lemon Party pills. Where did our Two of Hearts card go? Is it somewhere down there within the miasma? I must have forgotten it earlier, but hey, you know what? Lemon Party's actually a pretty good pill in and of itself. So let's just go fight Mom. We can skip one extra... Holy Mantle, thank you. So good. I know there's a red heart there. We'll get a red heart here, too. Everybody's gonna get a red heart. Yeah, this is shaping up pretty well. What did I tell you? I mean, Holy Mantle is just... When it shows up, it's too good. And I mean that... almost sincerely. We did take damage there, but we didn't because of Holy Mantle. We may still on this boss fight at some point. I'm just watching diligently under me. Oh, there we go. We took a little hit. Two little hits, but they're dead. gonna take the negative for sure. I didn't even use Krampus's head, which was kind of foolish. You know what? Sometimes power is learning to say no. As much as I would love... Oh, we should blow up the statue. As much as I would love Mom's Knife, and with these synergies it might be cool, I think let's not mess with a winning thing. We've already got a winning formula here, let's stick with it and not risk it. We got every enemy. What I like about Krampus's head as well is that it also gets the synergies from... Are you telling me this nub is actually going to survive that hit? But it also gets the synergies from your tier effects. So we actually did have Krampus shots that gave us charm tiers, which is very nice. Probably not a run winner or a loser, but the kind of thing, it's just nice, you know? That's Holy Mantle, at least saving us a little bit of indignity there. That's Holy Mantle again. I don't want to be here. Could Lemon Party out of it, but can't help but feel Lemon Party's a little bit better used against a boss. Petrified Poop. Yeah, you know what? Why not? We don't have any other trinkets. Not that big of a deal. I'm not going to be a snob about it. Petrified Poop is actually pretty good. 3 bombs. No, you don't understand. I'm trying to blow up this corpse. No, sorry, officer. What do you mean? What do you mean it's illegal? Who are you, Nintendo? I kid. Mostly. Oh, with Holy Mantle, we can totally go into our curse rooms for free still. And if we wanted to, we could take the nail. Or we could take Contract from Below. Well, Contract from Below gives us a black heart, but I think I'd rather stick with the red hearts, to be honest with you. But free curse rooms are free curse rooms, man. I'm happy. Oh, Jesus. Stop, please. I charmed one, but didn't kill it, amazingly. Oh, I thought they were all dead. Okay. Well, we know our deal with the devil isn't going to be amazing for us here, unfortunately. I wish that things were different, but they're not. Sounds like a Leonard Cohen song. No, this sounds like a Leonard Cohen song. He's a Canadian hero, okay? I like his music, I'm just poking fun. There's not many people I can do impressions of. So if you can at least give me a shitty one, I would appreciate it. Ruka, it's okay, buddy. I think we're gonna win this one. Ran in here because you were afraid of the vacuum. Now you want out. Can't have it both ways, sir. That's Flatworm. Not super interested in that. Maybe it's not Flatworm. Someone told me I accidentally mistook Flatworm, or I mistook Lost Contact for Flatworm once. But I'm pretty sure this one is Flatworm. Some of our shots are going to be elongated. You know, that actually seems kind of nice. Let's take it. Mama Goity. Now, we're not going to use Lemon Party here. But Mama Gertie, it should be nearly impossible for her to hit us with those spikes. I mean, it should be literally impossible for her to hit us with those spikes, but it should be nearly impossible for her to hit us in general. Especially with Holy Mantle. So I'm not even going to use Krampus's head here. I think it's better served on another room. Our item is going to be a speed upgrade, which is actually what I want. To be honest with you, that's very nice for us in this situation. We've been pretty slow. Alright, Mom's Heart fight. I would kill for the compass, but can't always get what you want. I hurt myself on the way in, somehow, despite having Ipecac. Not quite sure what's up with that. I deserve it for acting kind of rashly, but still. Could have waited to pick that up. Looks like we're firing like some poison lemons now. You might also call green lemons limes. We don't, you gotta forgive me, I don't live in the tropics, you know? I don't deal with citrus fruit that much, I don't work at a bar, I don't drink gin and tonics anymore so much. I guess magnetic tears don't really work against these guys. Ooh! Actually gotta aim your shots, that's why they're a little bit trickier than the other enemies that we've come across. If we lose this run, I gotta face that I'm off my game right now. Well, okay, let me put it this way. If we lose before beating Satan, I've got to face that I'm off my game a little bit. Ugh. If we lose, but we beat Satan in the process, I'll still feel like at least it was okay, and maybe the Lost got a lucky win or something on us. Not the Lost, the Lamb. You know what I'm talking about. Or do you? Trying to see if maybe there's some secret tinted rocks over there. Ooh, there's a secret tinted rock right there. Now this is what I'm afraid of, because now I have no idea where the fuck to go. Apparently we have not been down. Yeah, thank you, Holy Mantle. And actually, we're gonna get out of this without taking damage, which when I took damage like 10 seconds into the room, I did not think would be the case. And I shouldn't get too cocky, I guess, but there's not too many enemies left to get me. Could you maybe like not pop up every 2 seconds though? You should be dead. You'll be dead. Can't go to our boss trap room. Don't like this. There's Holy Mantle, saving me a little bit of damage. Without Holy Mantle, this run would be a lot worse. That's 2 Lemon Party pills. That might seem like, oh, Lemon Party, you know, it's, you know, very funny. Lemon Party is actually an amazing pill. I don't know why you became Sylvester Stallone when we're talking about Lemon Party, one of the best pills in the game. I don't know where we'll use it. Probably against Satan. Am I really gonna go hard on this? I think I am. We got Poison Touch, this is pretty alright. 2 red hearts for Poison Touch, especially with Holy Mantle. If an enemy touches us, he's gonna be in for some shit. In fact, the first time we get hit, we should take advantage of the temporary invincibility and go F with the enemy that hit us a little bit. There's our boss room. I'm imagining this one's gonna be pretty easy. We'll see, could be wrong. Start with this. Poison damage is not gonna work like that. There we go. Now, this is where Mom's Heart becomes kind of a pain in the ass. But we're firing fast enough, it doesn't seem to matter too much. Here comes the Brimstone. Oh, no, we're lucky. We might actually get to out of here without the Brimstone. I don't even think we used Holy Mantle there. And this doesn't give us anything, but we'll still go down a shoal this way. I think we've got a very good chance of getting the Lamb here. Which would be a very nice thing for me to take me out of this kind of purgatory I seem to have found myself in, where I'm not winning any Isaac runs. I mean, the game has gotten harder ever since I got the Lamb. But still, just some bad runs as well. No incredible synergy. People, they tweet me and they say, hey, you know, you've had some runs with great synergy. Do you think Rebirth's easier? Because that happens that often. Honestly, I don't find that great synergy happens all that often. When it does happen, it's spectacular. But I, you know, you can still have some long, drawn-out runs where you don't get very many damage upgrades and stuff like that. Maybe I'm just having bad luck, but I do feel the game's a lot harder. It's also just getting used to all the new stuff, you know, the way that enemies work and stuff like that. It's gonna take me hundreds of episodes to get to the point where I'm as comfortable with Rebirth as I was with Vanilla, if I ever get to that point. I hope I do, obviously. What am I thinking with this Lemon Party card? I am thinking that we probably end up using it on Satan. Probably we use one on Satan's foot, and then we use one what was that shot from me there? We use one on Satan's foot, and then we use another one on a difficult room on Dark Room. But I'm feeling very confident. We don't seem to be losing very much HP. Should probably, you know, break all the rocks. I think it's mostly Ipecac's doing. I think it's not really so much magnetic tears, but hey, I don't really care what's giving me the damage right now as long as we got it. Holy Mantle as well is the, regardless of who I thank if we win, Holy Mantle is the true winner here. Were it not for Holy Mantle, we would be probably screwed. Which is just normal, I guess. Like, Holy Mantle, you gotta give credit where credit is due, and that's an item that if you careful. Thank you, Holy Mantle. If nothing else, like, not even for saving me smart damage, or like damage against enemies, for saving me damage against spikes, I gotta give it some love. But if you're winning a run and you're not saying thank you, Holy Mantle, when you had it, well, you are ungrateful, my friend. Even if your mom's turkey is dry, that's not a euphemism, I'm talking about Thanksgiving. Even if your mom's got a dry turkey, you say thank you when she cooks you Thanksgiving dinner. Spirit hearts. Good for the future. If we need them. You know what? We have a real advantage on this room, because we can just do this. Can they spawn over here? Oh, they can spawn pretty close. More spirit hearts. Might as well check. We could also just bomb our way through these rooms if we wanted to. I don't want to. Luck down. Not so interested in that. I never thought I would ever, in my life, encounter a situation where I'd be saying, like, luck or Lemon Party is my secret weapon. But here we are. Lemon Party's my secret weapon. Write it on my epitaph. Print it on my tombstone. Brand it on a t-shirt. Bang it on a trash can. Drumming on a streetlight. Now, I'm thinking, probably just drop this right off the bat. Piss off the fallen. He's nearly dead. What? I thought he died there. We just lost Holy Mantle. And honestly, I'm okay with it. If we could kill him before we have to cross his threshold again, that would be awesome. That's damage. Shit happens. One hit's not the end of the world. Now, right in the middle here, we're going to drop a Lemon Party. That was very dumb damage on my part. But, I mean, you can see what we got going on here. It's working out pretty well. There we go. That's the good stuff. When did I become a person who says, that's the good stuff? That's what I want to know. So we know that we can go inside of that chest. Hopefully this doesn't ruin it. I'm just going to go back and get our spirit hearts. Not the bombs so much. No, the live bombs, I think I'm just going to let them stay there. Now, let's hope our red chests... I mean, there's still a small chance by going down to the dark room we could become Guppy. It would be pretty lucky. Oh, Curse of the Unknown. So we don't know how much HP we have. That's always frustrating. Well, there go our Guppy dreams for now. It's not Lemon Party. Can't take the spirit heart. I found pills and amnesia. Alright, well, we'll stick with Lemon Party for now. Let's go big room. Sometimes big room, small problem. We used Holy Mantle, but because I can fly... I really can't stop saying Holy Mantle with the cadence of Howie Mandel. Holy Mantel. Host of Deal or No Deal. Host of Holy Do It. Holy Do It sounds like it could be a show that's a little dirtier. But you never know, maybe Howie Mandel likes it dirty. Actually, you do know. He's one of the very few celebrities you do know that about. He likes it clean. He's a germaphobe. Most people don't know this. Howie Mandel does his patented Howie Mandel fist bump, which if you do a fist bump, you legally owe him $137,000 for every one you've done. He does that because he's phobic of germs. He's afraid of germs. There you go. There's some interesting tidbits for you. Did you also know, and people who have watched the show at all, the Twitch show we do, will say, yes, you've told me the story 100 times, Grandpa, but Mark Summers, host of Nickelodeon TV, goo-infested TV show Double Dare, also a germaphobe. And that strikes me as like the worst possible job in the world if you are afraid of getting dirty. Because, you know, pretty much people just got slimed like it was fucking Ghostbusters every day. I'm taking some damage. I'm trying to keep mental math. I think I'm down. I must be at 10 HP right now. Maybe 11 if I'm lucky and I didn't take 2 hits on here. But I think I took 2 hits here. Not sure though. Double Lemon Party. Sign me up. Get rid of that amnesia pill. I don't know how we use Lemon Party, but if we end up on a tough room, this won't do it. Well, you know, statistically, the longer this goes on, the less likely I am to take damage because you have started to get neutered a little bit, please. Okay, I lost Holy Mantle. That's okay. I lost Holy Mantle coverage. I didn't lose Holy Mantle. That would be devastating. I really should probably not use Krampus's head on these rooms because they're very easy. But his habits are hard to break. Well, we're not going to gain anything from using Lemon Party here. One gate needs to die. Thank you. Oh, that's why we're losing fire, or the gate's losing fire sometimes. His own bullets hit them. I found a... How many times did I hit myself right there? And what did I hit myself on? There's a secret room. Come on, dude. It's over. Accept it. Our wormhole has opened up. Oh, snap! It's the miter. I was cracking jokes earlier, but this is actually a big deal. Is this like a second secret room, or what the heck do we have going on here? You know what? Lemon party it up, kids. Get in here. Give your old man a lemon party love. That's gross. Don't ever repeat that to your mother. Not gonna do anything with these keys. I hate these guys. I used to love them, but then they started actually attacking. Double teratoma. Why does this seem to show up so often lately and, like, make me question my faith in Isaac? Don't forsake me like you forsook Scott Stapp, Lord. Oh, jeez. It's bad damage. I don't know how many spirit hearts we have left. I guess I know to be frightened when we start being able to pick up red hearts. I feel like we're more well suited to bosses, though, especially bosses that don't summon too many enemies. So it feels like the lamb might not be so bad. But it would be, like, real nice for me if I could, you know, get to the point where I could actually see the boss room. No, no, don't roll. This is not a Limp Bizkit conference. Not even a concert anymore. This is for Limp Bizkit middle managers and higher. Bad damage. Holy Mantle can't save you from that. One of you surely is dead. Look at how they're both so close. Okay, good. Now this guy's got to go before he does any other harmful shit. Nothing. Amazingly, still not a boss room available. There goes Holy Mantle. Oh, don't throw. Don't throw. This guy's got magnetic tears too. And they've all got fucking Betty Davis eyes. Seriously though, F off. Yep, okay, walked right into that guy. You know what? This is Lemon Party City right there. Should have done it earlier. Oh man. HP. Not HP, huh? Okay. Well, there's our boss fight, okay. This is winnable. That's bad damage. I'm not using it. Krampus's head is too valuable. Gotta save it. Oh, that's damage. That's like real human damage right there. I thought our refractory period would be a little longer. I had a nickel for every time I'd said that. Okay. Widow, you don't understand what you're doing to me here. Bombs. Bought with the balls. The dang dickies. Come on up, buddy. Yeah, there we go. I like that. I can deal with that. Can you deal with that? I doubt it. Apologize for getting a little manic here, but I really don't want to lose this one. And I'm seeing it slip away. Ouija board, that's going to change everything. Swear to God, if I got arrested in the middle of my win against the lamb, I'd be real salty. Okay, there's Holy Mantle. And there's Krampus's head. I don't love these guys. For reasons that are obvious. I've got to be rolling on red hearts now. Stop it. Stop with the homing shots. They're legit unfair, dog. Okay, stay away. It's actually going pretty well now. You've had a good couple of minutes here. Oh, that's not good, though. Whoa, okay, don't do that. The streak! It'll never end! Oh, we're at minus one. Still, thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. I think you can eke out a win there better than I can, but I feel real bad about that one. But hey, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, I'll see you next time.